Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics. This lecture is entitled Shift Registers in VHDL. Okay, so we are going to forego any mention of structural approach of shift registers in VHDL because we can far easier describe a shift register using behavioral approach. What I have is a serial in, parallel out shift register. If it's serial in, it stands to conjecture that there is one input, which should be standard logic. I'm going to make it a positive edge clock, and I want a clear input. Notice I've dropped an active low definition. I'm going to say when clear is 1, clear it out. If clear is 0, don't clear it out. Parallel out. I have a standard logic vector as an output. And additionally, notice I've defined it as an in-out. So it's a data type is in-out because I have to read what's currently on it so I can reassign it when I shift. Obviously, I'm going to use a process statement based upon the inputs of a clock or my clear. I'm going to go ahead and make a decision. First decision is if clear is 1. What do? Clear it out. The other time I'm going to enter this process statement, if there's a clock tick event and clock is 1, i.e. I'm looking for a positive edge in the clock. What happens then? Well, D is assigned to Q3. Q2 is assigned whatever Q3 was. So we're shifting everybody right. And how I'm doing this is this single assignment. Q2 is assigned Q3. Q1 is assigned Q2. I could do all those statements by themselves, or I can do it all in one statement right here. Q2 down to 0 is assigned the previous values of Q3 down to 1. Basically, I'm taking Q3 down to 1 and shifting them in mass over here. Okay, let's redraw that. So what I'm basically doing with that single assignment is I'm taking Q3 to Q1 and shifting them in mass to Q2 to Q0. Okay, basically with that single assignment statement. How have I defined this? Q3 is right here. Q0 is right there. I am still shifting it right. If I wanted it the other way, what would I have to do? I'd have to rename those particular stages there and the directional assignment. What does the simulation of this look like? It looks exactly like this here. What I've got is some D input right here, and D is, and then a clock input, and then a clear input. I'm not clearing it out. Here are my stages, and now I am starting in an unknown condition. First clock edge comes along. I am shifting that current unknown and every single clock edge. It takes how many clock edges? 1, 2, 3, 4 clock edges to get all those unknowns out of there. What is it sampling at that particular clock edge? Well, D is a 0. D is a 0. Input is 0. Input is 0. And that's exactly what happens at this clock edge, however. D is a 1, and we input our first 1. And what you see is this behavior as it shifts right. In this particular example, right is defined from Q3 to Q0. Right is downwards, if you can think about that. So let's go ahead and try. That was a serial in, parallel out shift register. If I wanted to make it a serial in, serial out shift register, what is my one and only output? It's this one, Q0, i.e., according to our diagram, the rightmost bit. So let's try another serial in, parallel out application. However, this time what we're going to do is a bi-directional shift register. Okay, and this is what I had mentioned earlier, is in this example, I have defined Q3 as the leftmost bit, Q0 as the rightmost bit. In right mode, what's it doing? Well, according to my comments, it's passing Q3 to Q2, and Q2 to Q1, and so on and so forth. When it's in left mode, it's passing Q0 to Q1, Q1 to Q2, so on and so forth. However, there are modes. Right is 1, left is 0. So it stands to conjecture I should have a general description of this. It's a serial in, parallel out, with a clock signal, a clear signal, and a mode selection. So I can either be in right mode or left mode. All right, so what is our VHDL entity statement? Obviously, a standard logic input, i.e. it's 1, it's serial input. For this particular occurrence, where are my inputs? I've tied D together, but there is a single D input, and it's in right mode and left mode. It's taken from that same input. However, when it's in left mode, where does that D go to? Obviously, it goes to D0. When it's in right mode, where is it going to? It's going to D3. Despite the fact that there is a single input for those two modes, they're going to two different places. What am I going to do with a clock, obviously standard logic, clear standard logic, and Q my output, it is a standard logic vector since it is parallel out. If I wish to make this as a serial out, where is my output in write mode? It's Q0. Where is my output in left mode? It's Q3. Additionally, notice that it is an in-out. It's a bi-directional because we need to read the state of something before we can shift it and reassign it. But it's a process statement. When do I enter it? When there's a clock event or when clear happens. Active, high, clear. That's my first priority. If clear is 1, what do I want to do? Clear it. Q is assigned the vector. Notice the double quotations, quadruple 0. Else if. Okay, now here I'm making a decision. What is my input? Right, not left. I don't know if you see this indentation, so there's another input. Right, not left. That's input, standard logic. That is my mode selection. When it's in right mode. Okay, what do I want to do? Just like we did previously. D is assigned Q3. Whatever D is, make that Q3's value. And again, we're doing this massive shift. Q2 to Q0 is now assigned the previous values of Q3 to Q1. All we're doing, we're shifting it right. We ask the first question. Right, not left is 1, then shift it right. If that's not the case, and there's a positive edge in the clock, what are we going to do? And right, not left is 0. What mode are we in? We are in left mode. At this point, D, basically whatever D is, assign it to Q0. And then what are we going to do? We're going to take whatever Q2 down to 0 was, and we are going to shift them in mass with this single signal assignment left. Okay, Q3 to Q1 now get those previous values of Q2 to Q0. And any single time what you enter that if statement, you're going to get out of it, end if, end the process. So the behavioral description of these things, it's really just asking three questions. If it's clear, if there's a positive edge and it's in left mode, if there's a positive edge if it's in right mode. Okay, that's all it's asking. All right, what does a simulation of this look like? Keep in mind, the way I've described this, Q3 to Q0, Q0 is on the right, Q3 is on the left. So if it's shifting it downward, it's shifting it right. Shifting it upward, it's shifting it left. So which mode are we in here? So right, not left. We're in left mode. Where are we again here? We're in left mode. How do I know? Because this mode selection is 0. What mode are we in now? We are in right mode. Whatever the contents of the register at that point should be shifting right, which it is. Whatever the contents of that register at that point is shifting left, i.e. it's shifting it, in our particular example, up, because the way I've defined those. Notice that those positive edges, it should be sampling a 0. Where is the 0 going in left mode? Well, it's going to D0. Now in right mode, it's sampling, let's say right here. Let's use the correct color. It's sampling a 1 on that particular clock edge. Where is it going to? Well, in right mode, where is the input? It goes to Q3. Okay, so it has a behavioral simulation of a bidirectional serial in parallel out shift register. Let's go on to another example here. Let's put it all together. Okay, truly universal shift register. It's parallel in, parallel out, right, left shift register. Okay, so it's a parallel in, parallel out shift register, bidirectional. It's got everything. What is the behavioral description of this? I've got a number of inputs now. I've got D input. That's my serial input. When it's in right mode, D is being passed this direction. Whereas if it's in left mode, D is coming in here, and through all these spirals, you get left mode. Okay, and it's progressing in that direction. However, when I want to load something, what happens is that basically I take this vector P, and when it's in load mode, P is instantly assigned to the respective Qs. So what I can do is I can shift the thing left or right, but what I can do is load something and then shift it left or right. And where's my output in right mode? It's this way. Where's my output in left mode? This way. And again, we can just do a behavioral description of this. Obviously, we've got D as the standard logic. This is my entity statement here. I've got a clock as a standard logic. I've got a P vector. That's my parallel input. I've got a load. When the load command is high, I want it to load P to Q. I've got a mode selection, right, not left. When it's in 1, it's shifting right, i.e. Q3 to Q0. When it's in left mode, 0, Q0 to Q3. Finally, I've got a clear. It's active high. When it's clearing, i.e. 1, wipe the whole thing out. Finally, I've got my output vector. In this case, it's bidirectional because I have to read the state so I can reassign it when I shift. Let's go into the architecture statement, obviously a process. When there's a clock event or when there's a clear. First question, if I want to clear it, what am I going to do? I'm going to clear it and it, okay? So when I clear it, basically Q is assigned the vector 0, okay? Else if, what's my next priority? If the load command, basically there's another command out there, call load. What does that mean? Well, if the load is high, then Q is assigned P. Basically, take this P vector, stick it on every single one of those Q outputs. That's when it's in load command. Is that synchronous or asynchronous? It's asynchronous because it has no mention of a clock signal. Do you need something that is asynchronous? I don't know. Okay, you may have an application that requires an asynchronous load. You might want to make it a synchronous load because you can potentially free up resources on your particular programmable logic device. But in this case, we're just going to go ahead and say it's an asynchronous load. Doesn't happen to happen on a clock edge. Make the same thing for the clear statement too. All right, so now we've got these right and left modes and the exact same ones that we did in our last bidirectional shift register. The only thing we added difference here for this parallel in is this tiny statement right here. If it's a load, then Q is assigned the P inputs. When it's in write mode, Q3 gets D, and Q2 to Q0, they take this whole block, shift it over, write with that single assignment. Same thing happens again here when it's in left mode. What happens in left mode? Q0 gets D. What happens is I'm taking this and reassigning that whole block of 3 right here. In which direction has it moved? It has moved left, okay? You can do those individual assignments if you wish. But let's go ahead and do a simulation of this. Right is a defined Q3 to Q0 in our particular case. The way that the vectors are drawn here, it should be passing down when it's in right mode, up when it's in left mode. First off, just figure out which mode are we in. So right here, we're in right mode. Right here, we're in left mode. Left mode. Notice here is the load command. At this point right here, I issue the load command. Where is the load command? It's right here, and it's asserted high the only time it's loaded. Well, check it out. What am I loading? I've purposely kept P vector at unknown. Okay, I'm purposely loading unknown. What mode am I in? I'm in right shift mode. So at that moment, despite the fact that I had data on it moving left, and again, previously it was moving right, at that point I loaded something. I loaded an unknown because I'm crazy. What happens is those unknowns shift out. What is being shifted in? Well, the D at that particular clock edge happens to be a 1, so that 1 is shifted right as they go through. If I had a particular number like 5 or 9 or whatever on that P, the parallel input vector, you would see that instantly, parallelly, simultaneously loaded onto those Q outputs. So again, the behavioral descriptions of these shift registers substantially easier to, number one, write, and number two, understand than a structural description. All we're asking is basic questions. If it's clear, then clear it out. If there's a clock tick event, move this certain set of data either right or left, depending on modes. And final question here we're going to do is add a little bit more functionality to it, is go ahead, load parallel inputs simultaneously to a parallel output. This concludes the shift registers and VHDL lectures, and let's move on to our next topic.